Stopblock.org. They've been doing a lot of work traveling across the country, visiting the local communities and local liberty movements, local justice movements, to bring the idea that just because you have a badge doesn't mean you have extra rights or extra privileges, and doesn't mean you have the ability or the authority to run roughshod on our rights. And along with that message, there's been a message of genuine liberty and the idea of direct action. Now we can make this change, we don't need to rely on politicians to do it for us. Because when we ask politicians to make us more free, we're only demonstrating how unfree we truly are. And that's one of the messages that we bring, and I'm glad to bring you today to chat with you guys. Be there, ladies and gentlemen. How's it going, everybody? First of all, I thank all y'all for being on here. This is awesome. I came all the way down here from the Shire, as John said, because this is, you know, this kind of thing has been happening in every town across the state. You know, people are getting fed up for good reason with the institutionalized violence that John speaks of. And, you know, myself describe as a, you know, as a human being first and foremost, and I believe we each own ourselves, and we should be free to act as long as we're not hurting anybody else. And a lot of us are here today, we're here for police accountability, because individuals who work for police departments have negatively impacted us personally, or people around us, and in some cases very significantly. So first and foremost, I'll talk about CopBlock in a second, but I just want to underscore the fact that we each own ourselves. You own yourself, and for somebody to act any different, you know, it's wrong for me to come out right now and get this man in the face, right? He did nothing wrong to me. But if I had a badge, it'd be the same. Just as wrong for me if I had a badge on. A badge doesn't grant us the rights. And as soon as it starts with us as individuals, you know, the shirt says, who owns you? We have to each internalize the fact. We own ourselves. And for someone, if this group of people over here wrote on a piece of paper, hey, anybody who has a hat on owes me $20. If they don't pay me, I'm going to put them in a cage. It doesn't make it any more right that they put that on a piece of paper. Neither does it make it right for people in the going in Austin or D.C. to say they have a right to regulate your lives if you've done nothing to initiate force against anybody else. So it starts with you as an individual. Don't grant these people any authority, and don't grant their text on paper any legitimacy. That's where it starts. And then from that, you know, we work together, we support each other, and we make actions transparent, because at the end of the day, reputation is what it comes down to. And bullies, they want to hide their misdeeds. They want to hide their actions that harm us, and that's essentially that's why the 100 cameras are driven out today to a lot of y'all here. And I love the fact that that's happening, because, you know, it's going to mean everybody's going to be, you're safer, and other people in your community are safer. So I guess I'll give you a little bit about CopBlock. It started about 2.5 years ago. My good friend, Daniel Freeman, some of y'all may know, was being harassed in his local town in Wisconsin, and he wasn't getting any justice through the system that a lot of y'all encountered. So he said, hey, I'm going to strive for accountability through the light, the disinfecting light of transparency. So he created a website called CopBlock. I joined him there. And CopBlock is a decentralized organization made up of individuals united by the shared goal of police accountability. So that's what CopBlock is. It's a lot of people all over the world, if you haven't checked it out, I encourage you to go to CopBlock.org. There's a submit tab. You know, we take submissions from people who are harmed. We take submissions from people that have good stories to share. We put them on the site. We share videos. We do all sorts of things, but we have a call flood feature. If you are arrested, you're able to provide a good overview of what happened, ideally with video, which is objective. You know, we'll do call floods. We'll have, you know, sometimes in some cases thousands of people will call on your behalf. And the folks with badges, they know, you know, just like what happened with Antonio, if nobody would have stepped up, if that video would have been in existence, you know, he may have just been continued to be harassed as he has been. But because he was vocal and he stood up for what was right, and people, good people around him supported him, that's how we make a difference. I think there's more good people in the world than bad people, and if us good folks stand up, like John says, we just have to stand up and support each other, you know, we can really have a difference. And my goal for CopBlock is to one day for it to not have to exist. You know, I want to live in a society where it's peaceful, where we treat each other right.
Yeah.
But But at the end of the day, again, it comes down to self-ownership, you know. So don't, if you see someone on the street with a badge on, and if they're doing something wrong, call them out, just like you call your neighbor out or you call a friend out. Because if they get away with minor things, very trivial things, I'll admit, like parking in a no-parking zone, then it sets the stage for something else. Maybe then they shake somebody down, they do a stop and frisk when they're not supposed to. Or maybe they assault somebody and they're not held accountable for it. Or maybe, you know, they shoot somebody and they're not held accountable for it. So incentives play a huge part in this, and that's something that we should definitely touch on is incentives. Because incentives matter. And right now, police, if you live, how many of y'all are from Austin? So a lot of folks. So y'all are here in Austin, and obviously, if I can guess correctly, you're not happy with the service you're being provided by these folks who claim to serve and protect you. But so what I would say is, you know, you should have the option as a free person, as a human being, you should be able to, just like any other good of service, the food you buy, anything else, every good of service should be provided via consensual interactions. Right now, the Austin PD, they say anybody who lives in this arbitrary political boundary, we have the right to steal your money and provide you with this good of service. And if you're not happy with it, come complain to us and we'll look into it. But what do they do? We've all experienced the kind of accountability you get from going through their system, through filing complaints. You don't get that. So that's, again, why it's important to film every interaction, even if you're walking down the street. You know, if you see something happening, start recording, frame the situation as you walk up, because hopefully you never have to use a video, but if you do have to use a video, then there's objective documentation of it, it's framed, you know, hey, I'm just walking, nothing, you know, da-da-da-da, you just frame the location, time, date, everything going on, and it's important to support each other. Again, I guess I'll go back to incentives. The Austin PD and every other law enforcement agency, you know, they say we have the right to steal money from all these people. So, which to me seems hypocritical. These are folks who say we're here to serve and protect you. We're here to protect your rights. But they first violate your rights. They first steal from you to do this. And I know much better. I would much rather be supported by my friends, people around me, than to turn to some strangers. You know, when you need help, you call 911. You know, when seconds count, the police are minutes away, if ever. Right? They may not even ever show up. But I want to talk about language a little bit, because even some of the other speakers up here, I heard mention some words that I myself shy away from. I encourage you guys to at least think about, but you have to do what you think makes sense for you. And one of the words I think we should unpack is law. And I would say law is what we would say is common law, natural law, universal law. We kind of know what's right and wrong. You know, most people know it's not right to steal, to murder, rape, things like this. We don't need to look to a piece of paper and say, oh, hey, these guys said it's wrong, I'm not going to do that. You know, so this is why, so I would say that's law, whereas like what they do over here in these domes is legislation, it's man-made, it's arbitrary. And when you grant a group of people the right to control your life, then what check is there? You know, they say there's checks and balances and they protect you, they safeguard your rights, but in reality, these checks and balances only allow for cognitive dissonance for the actors. You know, the cop may arrest you and say, yeah, it'll get sorted out. They may arrest you just for harassing. They may steal your camera and say it's evidence. You know, when in reality, they're violating your rights. As is the person who's the bureaucrat who's stamping your paperwork, as is the judge, as are these other folks. They're each culpable for their actions. And so I would advise, you know, I would encourage you not to just say, you know, a lot of people get involved with cop block and they may initially step up and say, F the police, you know, and right, you know, and I can understand that. I can understand that sentiment. But at the end of the day, I was in school for law enforcement initially, and I decided I could have a bigger impact on the outside. And I know if I was working for AP right now, walking down the street, and someone just said, hey, F you, you know, and I'd be like, yeah, whatever. It would just build up. I would just solidify my, like, thin blue line mentality, and I would not be open-minded. I would not be receptive. So I encourage you each to be an ambassador and treat each other, be cool, calm, and collected. Yeah, I guess we're about done. So I guess I encourage you to check out CopBlock.org. I got a few T-shirts. I want to throw these out to whoever. I guess if I'll leave you, but so I got a large. I'm not going to start recording them. So who would raise your hand and say that they. Who's say that they actively communicate the ideas, like they know themselves, and they feel confident communicating these sorts of things to other folks. Thanks, man. All right, I got a medium shirt, this one. And then I gotta never take a blue extra large. Thanks, man. All right, guys, I appreciate your time. Again, you're welcome. And I'll see you next time.